Who will be the Cardinals manager in 2019? Well, the guy in the driver's seat is driving the car as we speak. Essentially, his to lose. Mike Schilt has more than a decade of work in this organization. Fox News Sports Director Martin Kilcoyne sat down with the interim manager.
It's an exciting job, but there's also pressure with it. The owner has said, we got to start winning. The president of baseball operations, Mozeliak, says, we got to start winning. So how do you balance the excitement and also the pressure to produce?
Well, I think, you know, first of all, it's important to stay present. You know, you think about who we're playing, the schedule, and, you know, we have to do this. And, yeah, at the end of the day, that's true. But you only have so much energy and focus. So my message to the group, my message to myself is just stay present. Be productive in how you're looking to get things going in a more consistent direction, how that looks. And then try to what can we do to implement some strategies for that to happen. Clearly, it's not as easy as a snap of the finger. But the best news is we've got a clubhouse of guys that are really excited about moving forward. And you know, we're just going to go play the game right every day and prepare. And the byproduct of that will be the winning.
Yeah, the owner and Mo have said there's more talent there. We think this roster is more talented than it's shown. Are you confident this team can make a little bit of a move in the standings?
Yes, I'm confident, and this clubhouse is confident. We've got really good players, and the one thing that, you know, I mentioned about the consistency, the inconsistency, the one thing I want to make sure of is, like, let's don't forget what our strengths are. Let's don't forget we do have some really talented players, and that's been a message, you know, initially when I spoke with the club is, you know, we're all in this together. You know, to be number one, we're going to be one. But don't forget how good you guys are. And don't individually forget, you know, we got a lot of talent in this room. And let's just get back to individually taking care of our business and being ready to play. But yeah, we have the, and here's the thing. Like, we just want to find out if you're playing at your best, you know, not perfect. It's a hard game, as we all know. The other teams, other side's trying too. But if we can get that consistent level of play and we can get guys that, to perform to their capabilities, that's all we can ask. And that club will be what it'll be, but I'm confident it'll be a good version.
You've been their coach. They seem to like you. Now you're the boss. Does that change the dynamic at all?
I mean, clearly the dynamic's changed to a degree, but I'm not going to change. You know, everybody knows the manager's the manager. I've never viewed it being in a relationship where it, like this with players and staff. It's this. You know, candidly, players win games, you know, and my job is to make sure they're in a position to have the best chance to do that. And so I've got a responsibility, but it's the player's game. You know, people don't show up to watch me manage. They show up to watch Yachty and Carpenter and Dexter and Carlos and our you know, Jed and the group play. So, you know, it's their game. I'm here to manage it. We're here to coordinate to give them the best chance to be in a consistent spot to be successful.
You've been around the game a long time, including as a kid. We've heard the stories. Cal Ripken's in the minor leagues. You're there. You're carrying his cleats. At the time, Cal Ripken wasn't the Hall of Fame player he became. But how impactful was it, even as he progressed, that you said, well, that was my guy back whenever?
Huge impact. You know, I grew up in the Cardinal clubhouse and their AA affiliate in Charlotte. And that's back when the Orioles were the Oriole way, you know, and they were the winningest franchise in Major League Baseball from 54 to 79. So, you know, I didn't understand how fortunate I was to see it, you know, but I kind of learned my ABCs in the right manner. And that's why it was pretty seamless to come in the Cardinal organization, because it was very similar. Back then, it was a lot of continuity amongst their staff, their minor league staff, their major league staff, the teachings, and it was completely fundamental based. And so I just started to observe that, like, in Cal, he's 19, first guy in the clubhouse, how he went about his early work, how he had his own plan. After the game, he would go into Jimmy Williams' office, the manager, and talk about the game. And I just observed what that looked like, and it was a great modeling opportunity for me. And I did the scoreboard during the game. So for six, seven years, I'd sit there and, you know, the media guys would be there and they'd talk to me, but I was 10, 11, 12, 13, all the way to 16, doing the scoreboard, and by myself, I didn't miss a pitch. So you just, I'm just watching a double-A game every night for, you know, every summer for, you know, my formative years. So hopefully you pick up on something.
You've got this job for a couple of months. How do you handle the pressure, the back of your mind? Hey, if this goes well, this can be my job in 2019 and beyond. I know it's all about that day. How do you put that thought aside?
Well, you just said it. You know, you just said it's all about that day. Clearly, you want the job. But I got some really good advice, and the gentleman was just in a passing conversation. This was in, you know, 2001 or two, when I was talking to the gentleman who was scouting for the Seattle Mariners as a cross-checker in a game. And I said, hey, how do you, you know, you got any advice for how to get into professional baseball? He said, what are you doing now? I told him what I was doing. He said, be really good at that, and you'll be prepared for what that next step looks like. I just need to stay present. You know, I just stay present with what I can control, treat people well, treat the guys well, trust the staff, trust the players, create an environment where they want to come and play, and they're prepared to play, and they're comfortable playing, and they can play at their absolute best. And then today, that'll either be good enough or it won't. And that's the kind of the approach I've taken with every job I've ever had and every situation I've ever been in. And you know, you asked me earlier, like, did I ever think I'd be here? No, but that was me having that approach. And staying with that approach is pretty comfortable why I'm here, you know, is be able to grow and stay present and appreciate where you are and bloom where you're planted type thing. And I can't control what you and everybody else will say or do, and rightfully so. You've always got opinions and thoughts, and, you know, there needs to be I want what's best for this organization, you know. And if the end of this season, how it turns out, if ownership and Mo and Gersh decide I'm the guy for that, obviously I'm excited. If they say you're best suited for another opportunity in this organization somewhere else, yes, sir, tell me where I need to go and I'll be there.